Good. Lovely to see you.
When I grow up, I'll be tall enough to reach the branches that I need to reach to climb the trees you get to climb when you're grown up. And when I grow up...
Now don't forget that this is forever and ever. So the things that we're filming, this is the way that you'll look back at yourself when you've got kids of your own age and you look like this.
Ew, now. I don't want kids.
You what?
I don't want kids.
Why not?
Because they're ugly.
You're rude.
Tell me, what do you think about this school? What's the school like?
It's okay.
It's okay, it's fun.
It's fun.
Secondary school.
Bunch in together a little bit closer there. Yeah, that's... Oh. Don't kill him. Yeah, it's fun. What's the nice thing about it? What do you like about it?
Yeah, the sports competitions for me.
Math for me. I like English. Yeah. I'm just completely opposite to my brother.
Friends.
Yeah,
friends.
The most important thing. Yeah.
Best thing about it is actually having a wider group of friends here. Last year, I think.
What excites you the most thing in the whole world? What's the best thing ever?
The best thing ever, it's either looking at baby otters and very cute, adorable animals, or being with my friends. I'm kind of tied between both.
So it's either otters or friends?
Yeah.
Okay. And given the choice, would you prefer that, Max and Jack, would you prefer that they were otters?
That'd be awesome.
It would be cool, but it wouldn't be the same because they would be tiny little, not tiny, but small things that live in rivers.
Who's your favourite teacher?
I think it is Mrs. Bolton, yeah. And once when I was little, my mum couldn't come to like an assembly, and Miss Bolton said to me, "Oh, I'll be your grandma to pretend so like I'd have like someone from my family come."
Mr. Shaw! Because he's funny, good at sport, and he, when I do my flippy stuff, he pretends that he says, "Ready, 3, 2, 1, and he pretends to go. But he says, "No, I can't."
Mr. Shaw, Mrs. Lancaster, Miss Davis.
Mr. Shaw. He's the most fun and hilarious teacher here.
Yeah, very.
And so, but Mr. Shaw is very popular, isn't he?
Yeah.
Why is he so popular? What is it about him?
Because when he gets angry, he's not
he gets the job done, but yeah, he's not angry with us.
Yeah, he makes it groovy, which like encourages you to learn more, and that's what makes it cool.
What would you say to him?
I'd probably say thank you for helping me learn. It's been pretty amazing being here. Thanks.
I'd say thank you as well, because without you, I wouldn't pass my 11 plus. I wouldn't be where I am now.
You've helped me a lot, and I appreciate it. And you're just the best teacher ever.
That's all true.
What makes the teachers here good, do you think?
They're really, really happy, and they're always like, they're like a big family. We all a really big family.
Some of them are quite angry people.
Yeah, like, yeah. I don't know.
Can you do the face for me that they make when they're really the angriest?
No,
are you ready?
I can't.
1, 2, 3, go.
Hello. My name's Ben Keaton, and I'm here today at St. Helena's in Wilby to talk to the staff here about the state of education in this country at the moment. I have here with me Mr. Shaw and Mrs. Belton. I'll start with you, Mr. Shaw. So this year you're working with Year 6s, a very bright class, and I know they're moving on now, of course, in their education and on into secondary. And I was just wondering about your perspective on education in the country at the moment for this age group.
Well, it's dramatically changed over the last couple of years. The expectations are a lot higher. Current year sixes have really strived to get as close as they can to that standard, which they've done really well. The curriculum is very broad and balanced, so they're able to look at a range of different areas, so lots of art, lots of sport. As you all know, current year sixes have really strived to get as close as they can to that standard.
I hope they'll go many separate ways. They are a diverse class, which allows them. The curriculum is very broad and balanced, so they're.
So, Mr. Shaw, you have a particular student in your group who I believe is the most forgetful student that there's ever been here.
Ever of all time. Yeah. That boy forgets his head, his arms, his legs, his jumpers, all sorts. Emmanuel.
Yeah. Emmanuel, yes.
Yeah. We've used sellotape, a lot of sellotape, to stick letters to him. We've tied jumpers to him, tied him to his chair so he didn't forget to do the lesson. Just really controlling him all of the time.
Where am I?
He's only two or three times has he turned up in his pyjamas to this school, which we've encompassed, and that is okay. But Emmanuel, you can't turn up to school, secondary school, in your pyjamas. You just can't.
What are these?
Receptions, toys, like so bikes and scooters.
And did you used to use these?
Yeah.
Were they fun?
Yeah.
Kira, tell me a little bit about your outfit. Where did you get your idea for?
We got it at home because we both want to be like fashion designers, and we thought to start at a young age. It's like very heavy because it's like an old sheet that we got at the charity shop.
And what did you do to it?
We cut it up.
Because we were like playing with dolls, and then we didn't have enough clothes, so then we were kind of like chopping stuff up and making clothes, so then we just made bigger versions of them.
And we thought like it needs a bit of a collar, so we got like some ribbon and we tied it around our waist, and then we got some buttons and roses and sewed it on.
I really like to be a teacher, or to work with children is definitely what I'd like to do.
Farmer. Because it runs in the family, and I find it really good.
Probably a salesman, because then I could earn a lot of money and then retire.
Do you think you're good at convincing people?
Yeah. I've convinced my mum for me to get a hamster before Christmas.
Did you?
Yeah.
You convinced her with your sales technique?
Yeah.
So how did you convince your mum to get a hamster?
Begging.
What do you want to be?
Policeman. Because half of their jobs are exciting and fun.
Mm-hmm. Okay, what about yourself?
A PE teacher.
And are you good at sport?
Yeah.
What sport?
Football.
Football. Okay, what position?
Centre mid.
What team do you support?
Liverpool.
They're not very good though, are they?
Be a YouTuber and also like make videos if I see an animal on the side of the road, and then make a video of how to save them.
I would probably make engines and stuff, like fix cars and work on cars. Well, yeah, my uncle, he makes engines for Ford cars, but I find it interesting because you get to learn what's inside of cars and stuff.
Athlete.
Which one? Which kind?
Running athlete.
Which length of race?
Whatever Usain Bolt does. Does it count if I'm good at messing up my bedroom?
Yes. So how messy is your bedroom?
Once you couldn't even see the floor.
What do your parents say when you've messed your bedroom up?
The one thing all parents say, clean it up now!
Be a musician.
Ah, now what kind of music?
Death metal.
So, I'm going to zoom in on the guy who looks like an angel and wants to do death metal. Just see. So, who is your favourite death metal band?
Slipknot.
And what's your favourite track?
Probably The Devil and I. You don't have to do this.
The Devil and I.
See ya.
So you're going to be leaving here soon?
Yeah.
And what's that going to be like?
Scary but exciting.
Upsetting.
Yeah, I don't really want to leave.
I don't want to leave at all.
I don't. Because the teachers here are very nice.
And then it's going to
be loads of little friends.
Happy.
Yeah.
So we're going to explore a new world.
Mm. So is that exciting?
Yeah.
It's right before your eyes.
Shut up!
Step by step, you're on your way. Welcome to a bright day. Don't you know it feels good to be alive? You can be larger than life.
Bigger than the
peanut wall. You can have all your dreams from every boy and every girl. You can fly higher than the sky. Shine bright.
John, this is the
Yeah! I'll never forget St. Helena's.
Dear John, I hope life is great, man. Remember, be a YouTuber and don't get a girlfriend. Dear Max, I hope life is going well. Remember KB? Remember when you couldn't sleep at the Arts Residential? Do you still love Slipknot? Dear Amy, remember Kira is your best friend and she always will be. Dear Kira, remember that Amy Bialko is your best friend and that she will always be there for you. Meet Amy on the 29th of June at Willoughby St. Helena's and meet on each other's birthdays. Stay happy and have great times together because there'll be many more to come. Dear Jack, I want you to remember Keith and Company, the rescue dog team, and think back and say that you will be friends forever. And keep an eye out for those close to you. Dear Tyler, Carry your dreams wherever you go, because something good will always come out of it. Be successful. Dear Harry, try and exceed in life and be happy, because anything could happen at any time. Just be happy. Dear Caitlin, I hope you achieve your dreams of being a gymnastics coach. Always be happy. Also, believe in yourself. If you can't do something, just try, try, and try again. Always be best friends with Rebecca. Dear Jaden, do you remember Max and Jack from Willoughby? They were awesome. Buy your son an Xbox, he will love it. Be vegan as well. The date is the 29th of the 6th, 2017, Wednesday. You are 11. Remember your dreams and have fun. Dear Oliver, have a happy life. Dear Holly, have a great life. Be adventurous. Never give up on the dream of being a baker. This is our motto. Never give up. When somebody is standing in your way, just shove them out the way.